Hi everyone, it's Tish with Naptime Creations. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing the bloom technique with just paint and Floetrol. So let's jump in and get started. The paints I'm going to be using today are these King Art Metallic paints. And I actually won these from a giveaway few months back, I want to say. I won them from Nate Cerami and Stuff's channel. I'll link his channel down below. Go check him out. He does some really awesome art on his channel, and I was so excited to finally get to use these. They're really, really pretty, all metallic colors. So I'm going to be mixing these up, one part paint, two parts Floetrol. And when you use Floetrol, you always want to strain it because it can have lumps in it. And the thing I'm going to be using for my cell activator with this bloom technique is the Amsterdam Titanium White Acrylic Paint. And I mix that up 1 teaspoon paint to 2¾ teaspoons Floetrol. And you see the strainer, there's a bunch of like gunk and like gummy stuff in there, so you always want to strain your Floetrol. So I just went ahead and mixed up that titanium white really well, and here I'm just going in and doing 2 tablespoons of Floetrol, and then I will add 1 tablespoon of paint. I'm just going to show you how I'm going to mix up this pretty copper here. So I'm just adding my tablespoon of paint here. And if you put your Floetrol in the spoon first and then add your paint, the paint just slides right out of it, which was really cool. I didn't realize that with the titanium white, but when I was using these metallics, I was like, oh my gosh, if you do your Floetrol first, the paint just slides right out. So it was looking a little bit too thick, so I went ahead and added another 1/2 tablespoon of the Floetrol. So I went ahead and just mixed up all my other colors off camera. 2½ tablespoons Floetrol to 1 tablespoon paint. So I'm going to go in on this little heart cutout here with my copper. It's a really, really, really nice, pretty color. So what I'm going to do, as you can see, is I just poured a little bit of my paint down and I'm going to tilt it around till everything is nice and covered. And then I'm going to go in with a little bit of the metallic black, which is a really, really, really pretty color. I was like, oh my gosh, I wish I had more of this. I'm going to have to buy like a big bottle of it because it's a really, really pretty, almost like an onyx color. And here I'm going in with the gold and my cell activator, which is the Amsterdam Titanium White. So what I'm going to do is just give this some blows with my lung power and check it out. Look at those fun cells start to develop. See, my technique is so easy. I know a lot of people have tried it with like the house paint and the wood conditioner and all that stuff, but I haven't found that stuff necessary, so definitely give it a try. And then of course, you know, if you wanted to do like a bigger piece, just make your puddles bigger. I did do this kind of Dutch pour style on a 16 by 20 canvas. I will link that video down below if you guys want to check that out. It's a really, really fun one and it turned out beautiful. So here on my second one, I just went in with the silver, the onyx, and this is actually the copper gold. It's a really, really pretty gold. The names on these paints are kind of funky, like you would think the copper gold should be called gold, and then the gold should be called copper gold, and the bronze kind of looks like copper, but they're really, really beautiful paints. And this one actually turned out to be one of my favorites. The onyx gave some really, really nice lacing. Well, it's not onyx. I like to call it onyx, but it's the metallic black. So just go in and try to blow that white down and over your colors, and it'll give you the awesome effects. And check out on my glove, on my right hand there, you could kind of see I even had some cells and lacing on my glove. So at the tip of the heart, I just tried to blow a little tiny gentle poof of air just to kind of get that gold down there. I wasn't trying to move that white too much. So now on this guy, I'm going to use the silver, the metallic black again, and then I'm going to go in with the bronze. See, the bronze looks like copper, but it's actually called bronze. And then I'm going to add my cell topper, some of the titanium white by Amsterdam. then just give it a blow with my lung power and watch those fun cells and lacing develop. The silver is really, really pretty, but it's a really light silver. Like, I would almost say it's white. It almost looks white. And check out my gloves. Since these are all metallics, my gloves looked really awesome too. I was like, whoa, they were shimmering. This one turned out to be one of my favorites too. I'll bring you guys in for a close-up at the end. And I've done this technique a few other times with different colors, so be sure to check out those videos. I will link them down below in the description. They turned out awesome too. So here I'm going in with that copper gold, some of the metallic black, and then this is just regular gold. And then I'll add some of my cell topper. This one turned out really fun too. It reminds me of a bee because it's like gold and black. But I don't know, I like them all for different reasons. They all turned out really fun. These paints are really good. If you guys have watched any of my other videos, you know I just love metallic paint. So I was really excited to give these paints a try. And then same thing on this one. I'm not really trying to move that white. I'm just going to blow gently towards the tip of the heart just to get that gold down there. Kind of blew a little bit too hard and moved the white, but that wasn't my intention. And I'll bring you guys in for a close-up. So this is the first one that we did. And this is the second one. And then the third one. And the last one. So I'm going to let these guys dry and I'll show you what they look like when they're all nice and dry in about 24-48 hours. So to seal these, I used two coats of this crystal clear gloss enamel by Rust-Oleum. I didn't like this one very much, so I'm going to keep using my Krylon triple thick clear and my 2x gloss clear spray by Rust-Oleum. So here they are all nice and dry, and this has they have two coats of that gloss spray on them. They're just not as glossy as my other ones are. If you guys want to see the sprays that I'm talking about, I will link that video down below and put an iCard right here. Check out that bloom technique video, and I show those two sprays in that video, and they really turn out looking like they have resin on them, which is nice. These ones still turned out really cool. They have some really fun lines and everything stayed put. The pearl black metallic is just gorgeous. It's very, very shimmery. I think that one's my favorite color out of the King Art metallic set. But which one do you guys like the most? Let me know down in the comments. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it, and I hope you give this technique a try with just paint and Floetrol. It's a really fun technique. And let me know down in the comments if you guys want to see more videos like this or resin art videos. And if you liked it, go ahead and leave me a like. Or another thing that would help me out is if you go watch a few more of my other videos or even check out a playlist. Thanks again, guys. I'll see you soon for another video. Bye.